From an early age on, we've learned to recognize the warning signs and devices used for traffic control in and around work zones. These signs have become a part of our society, and we follow them almost subconsciously. But did you ever think about what would happen if we didn't have these devices?
Hello?
Hi, Sue. Just wanted to let you know that there's road construction ahead. So, try a new Tasty Bites. And by the way, Sue, the left lane is closed at the intersection of 40th and Grand.
Telegram.
Roadwork ahead, stop.
Left lane closed, stop. Be prepared to stop. Stop.
Now, I'll admit, that situation's a little extreme, but it does show you how important traffic control devices are for communicating with drivers. Remember, motorists rely on you to give them the right messages that will guide them safely through the work zone. In order for you to be an effective communicator, you must be familiar with all the devices used in safe traffic control.
In this video, we're going to talk about the control devices that you'll probably use most often. These are signs, channelizing devices, warning lights, and barricades.
In order for these devices to be effective, they have to first get people's attention and then convey a clear and simple message. It's also important for the devices to command respect so that drivers recognize and always obey them. And so national standards require that all traffic workers must use similar devices. You can find these standards in the Manual on Uniform Traffic Control Devices. Specific local requirements often exceed national standards, so it's a good idea to check on your local requirements before putting up traffic control devices. Now, let's look at traffic control devices in detail, starting with signs.
Traffic control signs advise and warn drivers and tell them how to travel through the work site. They communicate these messages through words, colors, shapes, and symbols. For example, the color orange is used for construction or maintenance, and a diamond shape is used for warning signs. Signs that are used at night must be either reflectorized or illuminated so that the shapes and colors stay the same.
Think about all the signs you see every day just driving down the street. Each of these signs belongs to one of three different categories: regulatory, warning, or guide signs.
Regulatory signs, which are rectangular with a white background, hold legal obligations on traffic and are always placed where the regulation becomes effective. For example, parking restrictions begin at the point where the sign is located. To avoid confusion, you must remove or cover any existing regulatory signs that are overridden by temporary signs. Keep in mind that regulatory signs must be authorized by the proper officials. So if you have to close a left turn lane and install no left turn signs, you should first talk with the proper agencies. Warning signs warn drivers of potentially hazardous conditions, particularly when they're not obvious or can't be seen by the drivers. In work zones, these signs are diamond-shaped with a black message on an orange background. Warning signs need to be far enough in advance of work zones to give the driver time to understand and react to the message. but they can't be placed so far ahead that drivers forget the message by the time they reach the work zone. Guide signs give travelers information on destinations, motorist direction, or detour routes.
Choosing the right type of sign is essential to creating a safe work zone for drivers and workers. So it's important to keep the following points in mind. Always start projects with a general sign like road work ahead. Then get more specific as the driver approaches the work zone.
Try to choose signs that accurately describe the situation. Make sure signs are at a minimum 12 inches off the ground or higher to be seen over parked cars or heavy traffic. And double check that they aren't blocked by plants, trees, light poles, or heavy work activity. Also, remember to place signs far enough ahead so they don't block drivers' views as they enter the work area.
Signs are an essential part of communicating with the drivers, but you still need a way to get them to go where you want them to go. That's where channeling devices come in. Channeling devices are placed on or near a roadway to control the flow of traffic. They direct traffic from one lane to another and guide travelers along a safe path.
Since these devices can be a hazard themselves if a motorist runs into them, advance warning signs should be placed well in front of them. And like signs, channelizing devices should always be retroreflective at night so they're visible to the public. Cones, tubes, drums, barricades, and vertical panels are all examples of channelizing devices. Each of these devices has its own advantages. Traffic cones are a familiar sight in road operations, and they come in several sizes. 18-inch cones are the minimum height for daytime low-speed operations. At night, cones must be at least 28 inches and reflectorized. For even greater visibility, 36-inch cones are available. Cones and tubes are compact and lightweight, making them easy to place on roadways and to store. They also fit well into tight areas between traffic. They are easily recognized by drivers, and they don't damage vehicles if they're hit. But because cones are small, they are easily knocked down and need to be repositioned often. Since constant attention is necessary, cones should never be used in unattended work sites. And although tubes work well when placed between lanes of traffic, their small target value limits their effectiveness elsewhere. Drums do a lot of the same things cones and tubes do, but since they're much larger, they command more respect from drivers. Drums are made of plastic materials, so they aren't likely to cause damage when hit. However, they can be difficult to put up, especially if the ground's uneven.
Besides cones and drums, you may also need to include barricades on your worksite. Barricades are usually used to outline construction areas, to close or restrict the right-of-way, to channelize traffic, to mark hazards, or to mount signs on. Like drums, barricades command the driver's respect, but they can damage vehicles when hit. Also, it's important that barricades only be weighted with sandbags placed near the bottom of the barricade.
There are three different types of barricades for various situations. Use single board type 1 and double board type 2 barricades where traffic is maintained through the area. These devices are especially effective in marking hazards because they're sturdy, even on ground that's not level. And use three-board Type 3 barricades where the roadway is partially or totally closed. No matter what type of barricade you're using, it must meet the standards outlined in the federal manual. All barricades must have alternate orange and white retroreflective stripes that slope down in the direction of traffic. Keep in mind that vertical panels can be used when there just isn't enough room for ordinary Type 1 or Type 2 barricades on the worksite.
All the signs and devices that we've talked about so far are effective tools for communicating with drivers and guiding them safely through work zones. And you can make them even more effective by adding warning lights. Warning lights are used to supplement other traffic control devices. They include flashing or steady burn lights, which are added to drums or barricades, as well as warning signs.
Flashing lights are used in the advance warning area and where there are unusual conditions and hazards. Type A, a low-intensity flashing light, is effective only at night, while high-intensity lights, type B, are effective for both day and nighttime. Never use flashing lights to outline the correct path for motorists. For that job, steady-burning lights, type C, are less confusing and guide the traffic through the work area. High-level warning devices are used to supplement other traffic control devices where there's heavy urban traffic. They're usually placed inside the work zone in the middle of the blocked lane and may be attached to a service vehicle or be freestanding. Three special traffic control devices are electric aero panels, portable changeable message signs, and portable traffic signals.
Electric aero panels are most effective when used in addition to signs, barricades, drums, or other devices. There are three important things to remember about aero panels.
The size of the panel must be appropriate for the type of road. For example, on low-speed roads, a panel must be visible for at least a half a mile, which means it must be a minimum of 48 by 24 inches. On higher-volume arterial streets, a larger board is more appropriate. Aero sticks or other lighting devices shouldn't be used in place of aero panels. These other devices are designed to enhance visibility, not to guide traffic. The aero must direct traffic into the proper lane. Never use an aero display to direct traffic into opposing traffic lanes. And if you're using aero panels at night or during bad weather, dim them so they don't blind drivers. Portable changeable message signs can display a variety of messages in the work zone and tell drivers about unexpected traffic and routing situations. Because drivers expect them to give accurate, up-to-date information, take the extra effort to make sure the message is always correct. Although portable message signs are generally used on urban freeways, they can be effective on any roadway. Remember that these signs are only an addition to regular signs, pavement markings, and traffic controls. Portable traffic signals are good for controlling traffic when both directions need to use the same lane or to stop both directions of traffic for equipment crossing. It's important to ensure that these signals meet all requirements of the local road authority and that all other necessary traffic controls are in place.
Whenever safety issues come up, visibility is at the top of the list. Visibility is the key to both effective communication and safety in work zones. It's essential that drivers are able to see vehicles, equipment, and workers. Let's look at several devices that help improve visibility.
Emergency flashers, flashing strobe lights, rotating beacons, and reflective vehicle markings increase both day and night visibility of vehicles and construction equipment. Agency regulations and requirements differ, so check with your supervisor to ensure proper design and operation. Two devices that increase visibility, particularly in heavy traffic, are high-level warning devices and Type 3 barricades with arrows. They are designed to be seen above traffic. The barricade is effective because it's easily seen and gives direction. It's extremely important that workers can also be seen by drivers. Wearing high-visibility clothing, such as a fluorescent orange vest, shirt, or jacket can help. And to ensure visibility at night or during inclement weather, these garments must be reflectorized. Other devices used to improve work zone traffic safety are fencing, barriers, and cover plates. Fencing is available in high visibility colors and is extremely effective in keeping pedestrians and bicyclists away from the work site. It's important that it's put up properly so it doesn't become a hazard itself. Portable barriers help channelize traffic and provide protection for workers, motorists, and pedestrians when they're used in conjunction with other traffic control devices. Since concrete barriers can easily become a hazard, use them with extreme caution. Or you might want to use plastic, water-filled barriers to lessen the hazards of concrete barriers. Steel cover plates allow traffic to safely travel over trenches and excavations. It's a good idea to consult a qualified individual to make sure the plate you're using can support the traffic load. And you may want to warn the public that steel plates are ahead on the road. plywood covers can help pedestrians over hazards in the sidewalk or keep children from entering excavations. Remember, these covers can become slippery when wet, and so you may want to use railings.
On long-term lane closures, 7 days or more, or even on some high-volume closures shorter than that, pavement markings should be changed to help redirect traffic. Whether paint, temporary tape, or pavement markers are used, be sure that old markings are completely removed so a clear path is obvious to the motorist. Traffic control devices are your primary communication with the traveling public, so it's important that you keep everything in the best possible condition. Devices should be cleaned regularly and inspected to make sure that all lights and electrical components are operating as designed. Replace all worn and faded devices on a regular basis. Remember, failure to maintain devices reduces both their visibility and effectiveness.
Even when they're properly maintained, traffic control devices still aren't foolproof. Occasionally, they get hit. That's why they're designed to yield on impact, so they pose only minimal risk to drivers, pedestrians, and workers, and won't extensively damage vehicles. There's also only minimal risk of injury from after-crash debris.
Safe traffic control means communicating effectively and efficiently with everyone who comes into contact with your worksite. The best way to communicate a clear, easily understood message is through traffic control devices. Now that you're familiar with the different devices available to you, signs, channeling devices, and barricades, you're on your way to making worksites safer for everyone, including you.